everyone. My name is Maria Lizelle Ubitos Campana, and today let's talk about something really important: 21st century assessment. With online learning becoming the norm, it's time we rethink how we check on students' progress. Today, I want to show you how assessment can change the game for education. Let's find new ways to help students learn better. Traditionally, education has focused on teaching, learning, and assessment as separate entities. However, in the 21st century, these elements are interconnected, forming the cornerstone of educational excellence. We are going to explore the characteristic of 21st century assessment. As we navigate the ever-changing landscape of education, it's essential to understand how assessment has evolved to meet the needs of learners in the 21st century. Let's dive in and discover the key features that define the modern assessment practices. There are 8 characteristics of the 21st century assessment, and the first one is responsive. Responsive refers to visible performance-based work as a result of assessment, generates data that inform curriculum and instruction. For example, in my Lit 11 class, I discuss about literature and some literary works. For me to know if the class understood the lesson, I will conduct a formative assessment in a one worksheet of paper, and the students will answer the questions, how does literature mirrors your life? And what literary work that mirrors your life? Next is flexible. Assessment need to be adaptable to student settings. Rather than the identical approach that works in traditional assessment, 21st century approaches are more versatile. For example, in my Principles of Teaching 1 class, I let my students have a survey of their multiple intelligences. After that, I group my students according to their intelligences and let them have a creative presentation. Next is integrated. Assessments are to be incorporated into day-to-day practice rather than as add-ons at the end of instructions or during a single specified week of the school calendar. For example, I assess my students from time to time because assessments are not just given at the end. I give my students formative assessments rather than just giving them summative assessments. Next is informative. The desired 21st century goals and objectives are clearly stated and explicitly taught. Students display the range of emerging knowledge and skills. Exemplars routinely guide students towards achievements of targets. For example, before I start my class, I see to it that my students are aware of the goals and objectives. With that, my students will be guided with their achievements. Next is multiple methods, an assessment continuum that includes a spectrum of strategies in the norm. For example, my students have different intelligences, so I see to it that I don't focus only on one way of assessing their learnings. Is communicated. Communication of assessment data is clear and transparent for all stakeholders. For example, I let my students keep track of their progress by returning their papers or evaluation sheet. I also see to it that I submit my students' grade on time for their parents to be aware of their children's achievements. Next is technically sound. Adjustments and accommodations are made in the assessment process to meet the students' needs and fairness. For example, I make sure that my assessments are valid, reliable, and supports comparison since my students have different intelligences, beliefs, gender, and socioeconomic groups. And the last one is systematic. 21st century assessment is a part of comprehensive and well-aligned assessment system that is balanced and inclusive for all students, constituents, and stakeholders, and designed to support improvement at all levels. For example, changes are inevitable, so I make sure that I am able to identify the needs of my students and the community. With that, I will be able to develop my students into globally competitive individuals. There are 5 roles of teachers in assessment. The first one is mentor, second is guide, third is accountant, fourth, reporter, and the last one is program director. As a mentor, the teacher serves as a supportive guide, offering wisdom, encouragement, and advice to students as they navigate their educational journey. They provide personalized guidance, helping students develop their strength, overcome challenges, and achieve their goals. For example, the teacher acts as a mentor by providing personalized guidance, encouragement, and support to students facing academic challenges. They demonstrate empathy, offer practical solutions, and instill confidence in the student's ability to succeed. The next one is as a guide. The teacher leads students through a learning process, providing direction, resources, and support along the way. They facilitate exploration, encourage critical thinking, and foster a dynamic learning environment where students can discover knowledge and insights for themselves. For example, the teacher acts as a guide by providing direction, resources, and support to students as they embark on a research project. They facilitate the learning process and encourage exploration and empower students to take ownership of their learning. Next is as an accountant. The teacher manages resources efficiently, ensuring that educational materials, funds, and budgets are allocated effectively. They keep track of expenses, maintain financial records, and make informed decisions to optimize the learning experiences for their students within budgetary constraints. Next is as a reporter. As a reporter, the teacher communicates important information to various stakeholders, including students, parents, administrators, and the community. They share updates on students' progress, curriculum development, and school events through newsletters, emails, meetings, and other channels, fostering transparency and engagement. Next is as a program director. The teacher oversees the design, implementation, and evaluation of educational programs and initiatives. They collaborate with colleagues, administrators, and external partners to develop curriculum framework, set learning objectives, and assess program effectiveness, ensuring alignment with the educational standards and goals. Let's define evaluation. So evaluation is the process of assigning value or importance to assessment results. It plays a crucial role in decision-making, guiding educational interventions and improvements based on students' performance. Okay, so as a teacher, how can we utilize the assessment results? So assessment results inform various education decisions, including instructional strategies, grading policies, student placement, guidance and counseling initiatives, curriculum development, and administrative policies. Okay, so what is the importance of crafting student learning outcomes? Student learning outcomes encapsulate knowledge, skills, and attitudes students are expected to acquire. When crafting students' learning outcomes, it's essential to consider instructional missions, government standards, industry expectations, and global trends to ensure alignment with educational goals. The characteristics of effective student learning outcomes are specific, realistic, focus on the learner, integrative, assessment-ready, and time-bound. Specific means clearly defined and ambiguous. Realistic means achievable and practical given the resources and constraints. Focus on the learner means center around the needs, interests, and learning styles of the individual. Next is integrative, combining multiple elements or skills into a cohesive whole. Next is assessment ready, designed to be evaluated and measured to determine success. The last one is time bound, having a defined timeline or deadline. Thank you for watching my report. I really appreciate your support and hope you found it informative.